Okay, ready guys? Breathe with me. Look at the mountain, beautiful mountain, calm and serene. Breathe in. And out. And breathe in. And out. Okay, hopefully we're feeling calmer. Because I'm going to try to talk about the Tim Chafer GDC sock puppet, not your shield fiasco. Let's be taking another breath. That's me taking another breath because this one's tough. This one's tough. Because, I mean, if you haven't been, you know, following gaming politics for the last little bit, you may not necessarily know why the connection between sock puppets and not your shield is relevant. I'm not even sure. Oh, who am I kidding? I'm giving him too much credit. Tim Chafer knows exactly why it's relevant. For people who don't know, a sock puppet is basically a fake second online account. And Not Your Shield, which is an offshoot of Gamergate, that is, the goal is to acknowledge the women, people of color, gay people, transgender people. I'm still going to say transgendered. I'm not going to say trans. But it's, you know, it's to acknowledge their existence, essentially. That's what Not Your Shield is. And basically, you know, this idea that, as I understand it, I mean, I'm not involved in the movement, but I know some people who are. The idea of Not Your Shield is that, how do I put this? People who are, you know, not white, cishet men, cisgendered heterosexual, that's what that means. We're using it so much, we've collapsed the word. The people who don't fit into that so-called, you know, top of the privileged food chain category, that they're allowed to have, I guess we, I'm a woman, we're allowed to have differences of opinion. We're allowed to make up our own minds. We don't have to toe a party line just because we're not, you know, the evil oppressor. That's what Not Your Shield is about. So, Tim Chafer, and there are people who believe it's not real. They believe it's just, you know, Gamergate fakery. And that's ridiculous. I mean, you spend 15 minutes researching the issue, whether you agree with them or not. It's a real thing. You know, it's a massive difference between agreeing or disagreeing with them and thinking it's a real thing. That's just common sense, which has left the building in a lot of ways. So, what Tim Chafer did, for people who don't know, is, hey, they're breathing too. What Tim Chafer did was got on the stage at GDC. I don't even know what he was supposed to be talking about. But he decided to be funny. At one point, Tim Chafer was known for being rather amusing. But he got up there and he had this sock puppet on his hand. And he said something about character designs and all that stuff. And the sock puppet said something along the lines of, you know, the equivalent of how many gamers does it take to screw in a light bulb, or how many gamer gators does it take to screw in a light bulb. It was on character designs or something like that, because he was talking about textures. But it was, you know, 50. One to do the modeling, one to do the textures, or something like that. And 40 to tweet, not your shield. And I'm sure he thought he was being very clever. But there's so much just... Now, to be clear, I'm not objecting to the fact... My primary objection is not to the fact that he went after Not Your Shield or that he went after Gamergate. I think that if he had made contentious, dehumanizing statements that were in favor of Gamergate, I would have had the exact same issue, because it's the dehumanization that's at issue here, right? Not which faction he supports. I want to be really clear about that. It is about tactics, not the target. Because the reality is that we can't allow gathering places to turn into political free-for-alls. We just can't. You know, we've got this, and I know this is a slippery slope argument, but I think this is also a best practices argument. You can't let this stuff start creeping in to these discussions, you know. Human rights is one thing. If you can talk about human rights without it being a left-right issue, that's great. Put it into your presentation. If you're trying to polarize and you're using a talk that's supposed to be about video game development to do it, I have an issue with that tactic. And I have an issue with that tactic because games are supposed to be for everyone. Games are supposed to be a place where anyone, the gaming community, it's supposed to be a place where anyone can come and feel welcome and feel like they have a place. And I don't understand. Wow, those look like mean fish. Now he's a fish stick. Whoa, tiger. This is getting dangerous. I feel like there's hypocrisy in Tim Schafer's messaging. Because one minute he's doing, and maybe there is no hypocrisy. Let's unpack this, see where we get with this. A few months ago, he was part of that 25 invisible benefits of gaming while male video that I think it was Jonathan McIntosh that was the Svengali behind that. I really didn't pay much attention to it, because the one thing that, you know, Feminist Frequency has going for it in my mind is indeed as a woman speaking her mind. When it's a bunch of dudes on the screen, I feel no reason to watch. The entire reason for it existing is gone. But so there's this 25 invisible benefits of gaming while male. And there's Tim Schafer in there. And I didn't recognize him at first. People had to point out to me who he was. Because I like Tim Schafer's games, but I'm not the biggest follower of him as a developer. So he was there. All right, fine. He has a right to support causes he believes in. But the whole idea is that was a message in support of people who normally don't get, you know, in his opinion, appropriate community participation in his industry. And now he's mocking another group of people for wanting a voice and community participation within the very same industry, and he's making fun of them because he disagrees with them on a single controversy. And to me, that's what privilege looks like. The whole idea of checking your privilege is so you don't do inane shit like that. Because that is sort of standing standing atop the gaming industry like a titan and telling people what they're allowed to think through mockery. And, you know, as someone who's been the target, I won't say victim, the target of nastiness from both sides of that equation, you know, I'm not speaking from an ignorant position. I know what it's like to have your Twitter clogged and useless. But in the grand scheme of things, it's really just a Twitter account, you know? That's all it is. And it only lasts for about 48 hours. And then you get those, I mean, it's a nuclear phenomenon, right? It's like, you have a really bad, you have a really bad 48-hour period, and then you get sort of these jerk stragglers. I knew you were coming, you freaking bird. Yeah, ah. Oh, moon, that's pretty. Oh, you. I hate you, bird. See, this is an overreaction, and I'm aware of it. But go away, bird. There. So where was I? I was talking about peace, love, and harmony or something like that, wasn't I? Yeah, that's funny. This is why people love me. No, I'm just kidding. So, when we talk about diversity, it's... I mean, where Tim Schafer's inadvertently put himself, if we're gonna be real about this, is... you know, oh, there's so many thoroughly offensive comparisons I can make to this, because it was offensive. I mean, you know, it was offensive. But, you know, Tim Schafer's coming dangerously close to having the opinion, you're not like those other minorities, whatever. There's a right kind of minority, and I hate the term minority. I hate the term minority, but we don't really have a catch-all phrase, and I'm not gonna get into that, you know, POC, trans, stuff. It's too wordy. But, come on, goat mask. Come on, goat mask. He's really getting into the territory of minorities are okay in gaming when I say so. And that's the definition of privilege. That's why do people not learn? I mean, I joked on Twitter that what Tim Schafer did is the, you know, 26th invisible privilege benefit of gaming while male. Because, you know, it takes either a complete unawareness of the impact you're having on other people or a serious set of cojones to go to a game development conference and bring your politics through the door. You know, there's a massive difference in using your personal political affiliation as a lens. And then there's what he did, which I consider to be using, you know, a political issue as a weapon. When you're up on a stage at a convention like that, you are ostensibly speaking to the entire industry. Which means you're speaking to, you know, left and right wingers. You're speaking to, you know, women and men, white people and the way we offensively catch all other minorities. I mean, I know that's a problem. Because... topic for another time. Okay. See how massive this thing gets? You start... peeling this onion, and there's a reason onion make you cry, because peeling one's smelly and time-consuming. But, You can't use a venue like that to attack. You can't examine. And I mean, people have done calls to arms, so to speak, in the past. I mean, we all cheered Manveer here when he did his, you know, diversity speech. But telling people to be nicer to each other is not the same as making, you know, inherently snarky, insensitive comment at the expense of a situation in gaming that has been exceptionally polarized, exceptionally charged. A lot of people have got burned by it. I was really hoping that people would either use GDC to reconcile, you know, the way Brianna Wu and Brad Wardell attempted to do good for them. Or at the very least, I was hoping people would just leave the whole controversy alone entirely. Because the thing about Gamergate, there are issues related to Gamergate. Yes, there are. Gamergate itself is a controversy. And controversies only hurt and dehumanize. Now, there was progress when we start getting, you know, sides of a debate team, for lack of a better term. But what hasn't happened is we haven't evolved into a discussion of issues. We keep getting hung up on these, you know, smelly little personality points. Like, we keep examining the people and not the issues. And the issue is that the way Tim Schafer approached this speaks to the core problem with the way gaming deals with diversity. A lot of people in gaming get scared of it if it's not something they understand, and they turn into a raging, trash-talking jerk. And I hope Tim Schafer realizes what he did was wrong, because I don't want to believe he's a bad guy. My personal bias, I don't want to believe anybody who's made a Sesame Street game is a bad guy. I just need to believe that Sesame Street is, you know, one of those sacrosanct, untouchable, everybody that works on them is a wonderful human being. And, you know, I'm sure that's naive. I'm sure that's totally wrong. But that's what I need to believe to sleep at night. Oh, I just died. That was not going to go well from the beginning, was it? But I hope he does learn from this, because his sneering is precisely the problem. People who are in a minority position should not have to have a particular opinion to be seen as human beings with inherent value. And that's what that's what a lot of Not Your Shield people talk about. And the thing about Not Your Shield is that it's an elegantly simple concept. Not Your Shield is essentially we exist, right? That's essentially the message of Not Your Shield. And some people don't quite get the inherent offense in Tim Schafer using a sock puppet as a mouthpiece for Not Your Shield. And I'm sure he was joking. I'm sure he thought he was being hilarious. And I'm sure the people there, it really seems like, and you know what, that's not true. There's plenty of people at GDC who either want nothing to do with this or, you know, are sympathetic to the Gamergate people. But there's been some really, and like I said, I'm talking about tactics. not targets, right? There's certain things that are just not right to do to anyone. And I don't like the, you know, SJW ribbons that I saw from GDC. I think that that is no different than walking in wearing, you know, a Hillary 2016 badge. Is that the election year in the US? Sorry, I'm Canadian. And I really like Hillary. I really like Hillary Clinton. I would never wear a political button into a game conference. Just because you want to keep things chill. You want to be there to talk about games. You want games to be a unifier. You are completely entitled to your politics. Just as I am. Just as anyone is. There have to be times that we aren't defined by those politics. Oh, great. Rhinos. Lovely. And see, that to me, gaming is about exploring other points of view in an interactive environment. Oh, the tigers are dead. And I, anything that, that's precious. You know, the kind of leave it at the door environment we've had up until this point. It's been precious. I think people don't realize how rare and special that is. And we can't afford to lose that because some people are angry or they feel personally besieged. And I'm sure that's why Tim Schafer decided to do what he did, was because he was... He got dogpiled on... people have been going after him. It's a rough time to be Tim Schafer for numerous reasons. Some of them of his own doing, some of them not. People make mistakes. People have differences of opinion. It shouldn't have to turn into a war. And to me, what he did at GDC was insecurity showing. Because, I mean, yes, we all know he's chummy with Anita and John. We know that. But that was, it was almost a pledge of loyalty in some ways. It was him kissing the ring, so to speak, because we all know feminist frequency is against Gamergate. And they are of the opinion that, you know, women couldn't possibly support that movement because they harass all women. This is kind of what it's like dealing with it. Whoops. Where are you, Rhino? Hi. No, please don't. Oh, hey, that worked. And I need one of you, don't I? Oh, no. Please go away. Oh, good. He's running over the other people. Maybe I shouldn't let the other people die. Uh-oh. Where'd he go? Oh, he ran them off a cliff. It's kind of like it's what it's like being in gaming right now. But I really think the way you approach an argument matters. And people need to be able to formulate and speak their own opinions without being immediately mocked, especially since, let's face it, in gaming, some of us might not be the most comfortable expressing ourselves. Social anxiety, just introverted personalities, a whole bunch of stuff. There's a whole bunch of reasons why it's important to be gentle, you know? And I think that's really being forgotten. I think in this race to define what gaming is or is not, people have lost sight of the idea that players are people. And that's what I was trying to do. And I think that's tragic. I think that we have a very unique opportunity in video games. And it's an opportunity to not make the mistakes that other forms of media have made. We have the opportunity to get it right almost out of the gate. Gaming's very young, right? So, what? Are you serious? Where'd these dudes come from? Are you up above? I'm confused. Okay, so, well, I'm running away like a chicken. I was saying about the opportunities for gaming. Gaming's pretty young, and for all the, you know, there's not enough women, there's not enough this, there's not enough that. There isn't enough. Enough is a difficult term. We do not have proportional representation of women and people of color in any form of media. I don't really know the stats based on gender identity. I mean, gender, okay. Other than a few cable shows and, you know, a character, a recurring character in Elementary, we don't have transgendered people in TV shows, generally. I mean, Chaz Mono's been a huge trendsetter in that way. But to treat the diversity debate as something that's unique to gaming or something that gaming is uniquely bad at is foolish. It's foolish in part because we have a cohesive industry. You know, we have a cohesive industry globally. It's not like, you know, film where there's Hollywood and there's Bollywood and there's pockets. When we complain about representation in film, we're talking about Hollywood media. There's no shortage of brown people in Bollywood, although then you get into skin tone and you know, remnants of the caste system and what's considered beautiful. But, you know, every lead in a Bollywood film would be considered a person of color in a Hollywood film. The white women are often the bad guys in Bollywood. Bollywood's fun. But, you know, so it's ignorant to start talking about these issues in gaming as if it's some sort of unique problem. And it's also ignorant to think we can get anywhere by, hello? Are you a rope or are you a snake? Oh, there you are. Hey. It's like talking to people about sensitive issues in gaming. Are you dead? Or are you floating? Whoa, that's not good. But, you know, the other thing that people have to keep in mind is that you don't tend to get anywhere by shouting at people. Or mocking them. Or turning them into sock puppets. And I have great love of sock puppets. For obvious reasons, if you know my career background. And I don't think it's fair that a sock puppet should be forced to tell such terrible jokes. I mean, really. We know Tim Schafer can do better. That was the other thing I forgot to mention. I'd be a lot less critical of him if it seemed like an off-the-cuff comment as opposed to something that was planned. When you include a prop in your act, that's prepared material. You know, if I could really understand a brain fart, you know, a stupid comment that he hadn't really prepared. And it didn't seem totally prepared just because he butchered the joke, right? He said 50, you know, it takes 50 gamer gators to design a character because, but, and then the math turned out to 1 in 40. That's 42. Right? So there was a lack of thought. There was a lack of preparedness in the material. But there was some prep in that he had a prop. He had that sock puppet. And he had obviously come up with the concept of the shtick, even if he hadn't necessarily practiced his speech. And that's just, you know, we've all winged speeches, but we all know it's something you probably shouldn't do for reasons like this. And it's GDC, man. It's not some little I mean, in the age of the internet, every speech matters. Trust me, I've become increasingly careful about playing the villain for a joke, because there's always a camera running, and people don't realize. I still get bloody assed about a stupid thing that was a joke at a satirical event. But the reality is, most people do not understand satire. As much as they'd like to think they do, most people don't. And that's why these sorts of venues are not appropriate places for politically charged humor. And I think humility and confidence are so critical on this point, and it's something that's something we do need to get better at. We need to stop being embarrassed of our industry. We need to stop apologizing for our industry. The gaming industry is great. The gaming industry is amazing and innovative. And if you don't believe that, why are you here? You know, it's not just about potential. It's about what we've accomplished. We can do more. Absolutely, we can do better. You can always do better. There's work to be done. But if people don't have what's done right acknowledged, people get discouraged and they just give up. And I'm tired of gaming hating on itself. I'm tired of it. I'm tired of... I'm tired of this belief that every time there's a conference, we need to, you know, whip ourselves in the public square to show how penitent we are as horrible oppressors of women and minorities. I mean, that is not the way to go. That just makes people nervous. You know? That just makes people nervous. That just makes people more hesitant to talk about it because they're afraid they're going to get their head bitten off. And guess what? That's a legitimate fear in gaming right now. That is a legitimate fear, I won't lie. People are just savage on this topic. So I don't want to condemn Tim Schafer as a person, but I'll definitely condemn that act, because it wasn't kind. It's not healing. And the reason you have a space on the stage at GDC is you're seen, at least as I understand it, hey, there's the mask. You're seen as some sort of thought leader in gaming. You've earned your place there, and you're seen as someone in the industry that people should listen to. Because of that, you should not use that opportunity when so many eyes are on you and you have the opportunity to do a lot of good. You should not use that to make fun of any group, no matter how thoroughly you disagree with them, because that is not leadership. That is not advocating diversity. That's not encouraging people to be respectful with people they don't like. That's perpetuating the problem that people claim to be against. I do not want to go to a show or a convention or any sort of gathering where people are handing out ribbons that say SJW. I do not want to go to an event where people think it's okay to mock an organization which, you know, is for women and minorities. You think it's not, but you can't prove it. And I'm not trying to erase gay people. I'm just, like I said, I'm trying to keep this less wordy. But there's so much conspiracy theory. There's so much tinfoil hatting going on. And people do it, and then they complain when the exact same faulty logic gets applied to them. Innocent until proven guilty, folks. Take people at their word unless you have reason not to. This is video games. This is not, you know, this is not a, this is not the UN. This is not a nuclear deal. This is video games. And I just personally think everything goes much better. Everything goes much smoother, and you get more done when you take people at their word unless you're given reason not to. And I think we all need to start remembering that. So I personally hope Tim Schafer doesn't get beat up too badly, because that won't solve anything. It'll just make him more bitter. But I do think that somebody who he will listen to seriously needs to sit him down and remind him that when you go after anybody, especially as a rich white man, you are part of the problem. He is not helping women by acting like a jackass. He is not helping people of color by acting like a jackass. When you act like a jackass, you help no one. And I'm not talking about people, you know, like Dan Savage or somebody like that who are professional contrarians. That's what he does. That's his brand. You know, Tim Schafer made a Sesame Street game. Brutal Legend was a little, you know, off color, but because it was metal, but it was still cuddly. And, you know, people looked at Tim Schafer because, you know, Psychonauts was one of the games that was sympathetic to mentally ill people. You know, they made mental health a gameplay mechanic in a positive way. You know, it was your health bar and things like that. And I think that's part of the reason that people are so bothered by what he said. And it's no, maybe you should listen to him and drop the tag. Or no. People have the right to express their views. And even if you think it's annoying, no skin off your nose. You know, everybody's got to start listening more to each other. I'm getting really sick of the paranoia and the factional politics. It is starting to just tear people apart. People have to get back on message. They have to get back on talking about the issues, and they have to stop attacking people, period, everyone, if we're going to get anywhere with this whole thing. So that's my take on it. I'm sure I'll get into tons of trouble, as I always do, because people just love to take something I say that's a 3 and make it into an 11, because that's more fun. I'm just the enemy, right? But that's my own bitterness, and I don't expect anyone wants to own this. So we're going to find a mountain, and we're going to breathe again. Ready? Mountain. And breathe in. And out. And in. And out.